Due to declining codling, for me, the months of December and January at Dungeness means dam fishing. I tend to head for the area between the points and a power station. This video covers two sessions at the Coastguard's mark. This is halfway between the boards and the first bird hide. You can catch the dabs at various states of the tide, both during the day and at night. In this first session, I'm fishing over low water and just as the tide is coming in. My baits are dungy blacks, both fresh and a few days old, and sprats for tipping. Boom rigs help with nailing the baits on the bottom. I normally allow one rig to drift, so I'm starting off by casting a rig with a continental lead, an Americano in this case. If the currents or tidal pull is too strong, then I will change over to one with wires. I'm trying to keep the rods fairly low, since I am after flatfish. As I'm setting up my second rod, I'll run through the locational details. Some of my previous Dungeness videos have covered the regional setting. Here I'm zooming straight in on Dungey itself. Running through the West Beach marks, which are known for dabs, you've got Dench Marsh, the Diamond, the area either side of a boil, and the boards. The points and the boats don't seem to be as good, in my opinion, regarding numbers of dabs, although some bigger ones can turn up there. As already mentioned, the Coast Guard area is between the first bird hide and the boards. Parking is by the gate to the concrete road which runs along the border of the power station. Here I've identified the two spots that I've fished for this video. My reels are loaded with 30-pound braid. I'm not expecting to cast huge distances, and it might be snaggy or weedy. When I'm fishing with two boom rigs, I normally like to have one with shorter wires for fishing further out, but in this case, both rigs have got medium to long wires, with one rig having them spread right out, and the other one having one boom close to the lead. There doesn't seem to be much in the way of currents or tidal pull, so here I'm still using a continental lead. Before I could finish baiting up my second rig, I've already got a bite on my first. Well, it's a fish, but unfortunately it's not a dab, it's a whiting, and that could be a problem today. Here's an obligatory look at my setup and the rigs employed. I don't always get a quick response, I'm very keen on dragging my baits. As soon as I've dragged the rigs, I get little knocks on both rods. These are typical whiting bites, and it's a decision I've got to make as to which rod to strike first. I decided to strike both rods, and I'm expecting to have fish on both of them. Sure enough, there's still a fish on my second rod. Or rather, my first double shot of whiting. Another double shot of whiting, and once again there's a little bit of annoying weed on the leader knot. This is getting stuck in top ring, making things rather difficult. The weed continued to be a bit of a problem, and I carried on up until sunset. Most casts produced double shot of whiting, and that got a little bit annoying. I just couldn't get through them to find anything different. Here's a triple shot to finish off this segment of video. A beautiful sunset, but I just couldn't get through those whiting. I was back towards the end of January and fishing a flood tide up to and over high water. The tide was coming in very quickly and I had set up a bit too close to the water's edge. That necessitated an early move up the beach. I decided to move right up to the strand line. Conditions looked perfect today, with light winds and a flat sea. Well, that's a great start. A triple shot, and they're not whiting, they're dabs. There's a bit more of a current today, and I've started with pyramid leads, which have a bit more grip. I'm now swapping the lead on my second rig over to one with wires. I don't really want this rig drifting down towards the other one and possibly getting tangled up. I've missed one bite, but I think I've connected with the next. And it's dab number 4. Again, nothing really to write home about. Quite a nice looking fish, and again, I'd rather be catching these than whiting. There's a bit of floating rubbish and weed now knocking into the line. The wind then changes direction and it gets distinctly cold. Slightly better dab this time. You may notice that this reef's got shorter booms than the ones I was using last time. I'm having to cast about 60 yards to get bites. No bites forthcoming, closer in than that. All of the rigs in this video have got size 3 or 4 hooks to 5 inch hook lengths. That's what I like to see, another triple shot. Water's a lot clearer this session, and I think that might be putting the whiting off. That allows other fish to have a look in. I'm using the same baits as before, and it doesn't really seem to make much of a difference what I've got on a hook. Sticky black lug of a few days old does tend to outperform fresh lugworm, but I'm not finding that the fish are having any preference today, and tipping with small bits of sprat is also inconclusive. I normally chop up the sprats into small triangular shapes. These don't need to be much bigger than a thumbnail, although sometimes a dad will take a whole sprat. The temperature has now dropped considerably, cold enough for me to have to put gloves on. A good bite that time, but the end result is the smallest stab of the day. The tide has now started to ebb, and there's quite a strong pull from my right to my left. Weed is becoming a bit of a problem again. Over the top of tide and just into the ebb, you can normally catch about 40 yards out, but that's not the case today. I need to chuck it a bit further out than that. This was the last fish of the day, and it's number 10. I could have fished on a lot more. I'm sure I would have caught about an hour and a half down the tide. However, I was freezing cold, and although it wasn't as hectic as the last time, I was pleased with the number of fish I had caught, since it was quite a slow session, and most of all, I was pleased that they were all dabs.
Oh, I got a flat eight.